I want all my devotees to bring this powerful cognition, strategy in your life. Meditate on this today. This is the essence of all my teachings. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Non-violence is biggest law of life. I want each one of you to understand what I am saying. Start in your personal life, in your family. Hey, all this asking for justice is delusion. Asking for justice is the cunning way you will be trapped into the war, and finally your whole life will be destroyed. Whoever did not listen to this teaching of Krishna is responsible for Mahabharata war. Krishna tried his best. Apply this principle in your life. Krishna tried non-violence and ahimsa as a strategy. He literally begged. He himself went as a peace ambassador to Duryodhana's court, where he was disrespected without even being given a seat. Why should he face all that abuse he faced? But the collective negativity was so much, it was unavoidable. That is why finally he decided, at least let me manage the scene personally, and that let the destruction be lowest. Let weapons be destroyed so that no other future destruction is possible. It is like a controlled conditions, diffusing all the nuclear weapons. That's exactly Krishna did. He diffused all the nuclear weapons, Brahmastras, in controlled condition so that the future humanity has a safe future. No fool can go cranky and destroy the humanity just because of his whims and fancies. So Krishna has tried his best and did his best. Listen. Now I am telling you, I want each one of you to understand this one ahimsa paramo dharma as the strategy. Do not waste time in the deluding concept called justice. I tell you, usually people who attack you, after attacking, they will cry victim and ask for justice. Anyone asks for justice falls into the delusion and gets into war directly or indirectly and wastes the whole life, even if he wins in the end. I am telling you, start applying this principle, ahimsa paramo dharmaha, inside you to bring completion. Inside your family to bring completion. Listen, I will do tyaga of any extreme and make sure there is no conflict with the people who are living around me, who gave their life to me, for whom I am giving my life, with whom I am committed. Then extend that to the office, your team. Then extend that to the sangha, teamily. Family, team, teamily. Family is immediate biological family. Team is office, your office. Teamily is sangha. Extend this to all three. This is the biggest lesson from my mother's life to all my daughters and sons. because of my presence, there will not be any conflict. I will be verily part of Swamiji's life and Sangha. I will be absolutely active and contributing everything best I can do, and make sure I will do such extreme tyaga that there will not be conflict between me and the Sangha, or any conflict due to my presence. I tell you, there are so many people trying to tell me, oh, I am okay and great with Swamiji, but this admin gang need to be taught a lesson. They don't respect me, they don't care for me, they don't know the great contribution I am doing, I have done to the Sangha. All these are absolute delusion and arrogance. Whoever decides, I will be with Swamiji, I will not leave him as orphan, or I will not make myself feel orphan by leaving Swamiji. I will be with Swamiji verily, honoring my integrity and commitment, and I will make sure I will do the tyaga, and there will not be any conflict because of my presence. And all these stupid fellows ask, oh, how much tyaga I can do, how much ever tyaga I do, they exploit me. All these are delusion. Deluded people feel exploited. Tyagis feel only showered. If you are feeling exploited, you are deluded. You are exploiting others. If you feel showered, you are a tyagi. You are showering on others. That's the truth.